Hi, my name is Mike Schwarz and I'm the Managing Director of iTech Minerals. Today I'm really pleased to be able to bring to you our new upgraded mineral resource estimate for the Eyre Peninsula Graphite Project. When we started drilling at our new La Croma graphite deposit over 12 months ago, our aim was to bring our total inventory of graphite resources on the Eyre Peninsula to well over 30 million tonnes. So I'm very pleased to be able to announce today that our new global graphite mineral resource estimate for the Eyre Peninsula project is 35.2 million tonnes at 6% total graphite carbon. So that is a massive increase from our historical resources that we had on that project. Plus, I've also got a question from an investor about our Reynolds Range project, which I'll do my best to answer at the end. So first, I'd like to talk about this exciting new mineral resource estimate. So what's really important are that 65% of those new resources have all gone into the higher confidence indicated category. Now, if you have inferred resources, which is the lowest level of confidence, you can't use those in any mining studies because they're at a pretty low level of confidence in your interpretation. But once you get up to indicated, you're able to use those in scoping and feasibility study work. So yeah, it's absolutely exceptional that 65% of those new resources are now into that indicated category. So we have significantly expanded our mine life for the whole Eyre Peninsula Graphite Project now. We believe it takes us anywhere from 10 years previously to now expanding that over to in excess of 30 years with our 35.2 million tonnes at 6%. So that's a significant increase in our potential operating mine life as well. So there are a number of other geological characteristics that also lead us to believe that we have the potential for very low operational costs and very low capital costs at La Croma. The mineralisation daylights, it outcrops at surface and it dips quite shallowly towards the east. So that means that from day one, you are mining ore material and you're not spending a lot of money removing the high cost overburden from the top of the deposit. You're mining it straight away. The other thing that's very important about La Croma is that it is very deeply weathered and the graphite is essentially hosted in a very soft clay material. So that is likely to bring our mining costs down significantly as well. The other thing is that when you've got a soft clay material, it's so much easier to be able to break that up and separate the graphite out of it in the concentrator plant as well. And that is shown in our initial metallurgy where we've got that 94% con with 95% recovery. So that essentially means that we can recover just about all of the graphite from the ore at La Croma. So with the definition of this significant new resource on the Eyre Peninsula, we now have the confidence to move forward to the next phase of developing this exciting project. And we look forward to helping the world meet the graphite shortages that many analysts are predicting over the next decade. So now I've also received a question from an investor and it says, hi Mike, regarding the Reynolds Range project, Prodigy has done a fair bit of drilling for copper and gold across these prospects. What interests you about this project? And this one's from James. So thanks for the question, James. And I'd like to give you some of my thoughts about what we find so interesting and compelling about the Reynolds Range project. So my initial response to that question is Prodigy did a reasonable amount of work on that project, as did some of the explorers before them. Now, most of the companies that have worked on Reynolds Range have been purely gold focused. What has been applied to the Arunta area, which is the geological province, is that they mainly used the West Australian style approaches to gold exploration, where they did large scale lag sampling and they also did RAB drilling, which is a quick and dirty drilling method, which gives you lots of contamination. They drilled down to 2 to 3 meters generally to get to hard rock and then to see if there was gold. Now, what that does in Western Australia is it targets the supergene gold, which is where you get gold enriched in the weathering profile at surface. Now, there's no supergene zone at Reynolds Range, so that style of exploration really fails to explore the area adequately. And then we have the opportunity to bring new exploration methodologies to target both the gold, but more importantly, focus on copper, gold and base metals, which none of the explorers before us really, really had a focus on. The other thing that's never been looked for at Reynolds Range and has never really been addressed at all in that area or any nearby provinces is the potential for lithium mineralisation. So we've gone out there recently into the field, had a look, and pleasantly surprised that there's over 60 kilometres of strike extent of pegmatites across that whole tenement, and they're exposed quite well in outcrop across that whole 60 kilometres. So when we were out there recently, we went to some of the old tin mines, which have historically been associated with lithium mineralisation, and we sampled many of those pegmatites for lithium. And those samples are in with the labs now, and we are hoping to get those results back in the coming week or so. So we'll be reporting those to market when they become available. So hopefully that answers your question. If you have a question for myself or any of the iTech team about any of our projects, please jump onto our website and send it through, and I'll try and answer it for you and any other investors on my next exploration update. As always, please make sure you subscribe to our email list and our YouTube channel so that you never miss an update in the future. Thanks for watching.